Hello students, welcome again to the next video of the lecture series. And in our video lecture series we were discussing about the system that was named as the endocrine system. But before starting our today's topic, one a request to you people that please do subscribe my channel and press the bell icon, and so that to get the video notifications whenever I will upload any video. So let's start. We were studying about the endocrine system. और endocrine system में हमने क्या पढ़ा था? इसमें हमने पढ़ा था about the hypothalamus. इसमें हमने पढ़ा था about the pituitary gland. Both of them were located in the brain. And the next gland, that is the today's topic, that is the pineal gland. This gland is also present in our brain. As on your screen you are seeing that the pineal location of the pineal gland, this gland is also present in the same structure, that is the diencephalon of the forebrain. But this pineal gland, this is present on the epithalamus. This is a P-shaped gland which is present on the epithalamus part of the this very diencephalon. And this the size of this is the same that of the, we can say, rice grain. Rice grain, the size of the pineal gland. After that, the pineal gland, it is a P-shaped gland. And this pineal gland, this secretes a hormone, single hormone, that is known as the melatonin. ये जो pineal gland होता है, ये एक hormone secrete करता है, a single hormone that is secreted by the pineal gland, that is the melatonin. And the melatonin, what is the function of melatonin? Pineal gland, इसकी location हमने बताई, इसका structure P-shaped gland है, and size भी हमने इसका बता दिया. After that, the hormones of the pineal gland, it is location we also discussed it. The pineal gland, it secretes a single hormone that is known as the melatonin. And what is the function of the melatonin? The melatonin, it regulates, it has various functions, like it regulates our sleep, it controls our sleep, it controls our mood, yeah, it also regulates our sexual cycle, yeah, like sexual development, huh? Yeah, time of maturity of the puberty, sexual development, we can see. These are the various functions of the melatonin, huh? And usually the melatonin that is secreted more during the night, during the darkness, as compared to the day. That is why, because of this very hormone, this hormone is secreted in the darkness, and this is the hormone which help us to fall asleep, huh? That is the function of this very hormone, that is known as the melatonin, huh? One more thing about the pineal gland. This pineal gland, this is also known as the third eye. इसको हम तीसरी आँख भी बोलते हैं, because this is the gland which controls, yeah, which detects the light, in the by the help of eyes, by the help of the our eyes receive the light and send that light to the, by the help of optic nerve, to the pineal gland. And whenever there is a darkness, the by the help we fall sleepy because of the hormone that is known as melatonin, huh? And then that was all about the hormone that was known as, yeah, that is known as the melatonin, huh? After that, the next gland of the endocrine system, that is known as the thyroid gland. And ये जो thyroid gland होता है, this is the largest endocrine gland, not exocrine, this is the largest endocrine gland. And as you are watching, yeah, you are seeing on your screen the shape of the thyroid gland and its location. This thyroid gland, this is a bilobed structure. This is a bilobed H-shaped structure, as you are seeing on your screen. The shape of the gland, that is the thyroid gland, this is the largest endocrine gland and is the bilobed. It is the two chambered structure and its shape is as that of the alphabet, that is known as H alphabet, huh? And after that, this is what, where is the location? You saw, see, ye jo thyroid gland hota hai, ye kahan pe present hota hai? It is present in our throat region, below the larynx, in front of the trachea, in front of the trachea, in front of the windpipe, below the larynx. This is the position of the thyroid gland. After that, this is the bilobed gland, S-shaped gland, and this hormone is the largest endocrine gland. After that, the thyroid gland that secretes the two types of hormones. The first hormone that is secreted by the thyroid gland, that is known as thyroxine, and the next hormone that is secreted by the thyroid gland, that is known as calcitonin. These are the two hormones which are secreted by the thyroid gland. Now, what is the function of thyroxine in our body? What is the function of the calcitonin in our body? Let's discuss the first hormone, that is known as thyroxine. This thyroxine, what is the function of thyroxine? Is thyroxine ki ka क्या काम है हमारी बॉडी में? दिस इज द थायराइड, दिस इज द हार्मोन विच कंट्रोल्स नंबर ऑफ फंक्शंस इन आवर बॉडी, लाइक इट कंट्रोल्स आवर बीएमआर. बीएमआर स्टैंड्स फॉर बेसल मेटाबॉलिक रेट. इट आल्सो हेल्प्स इन द इट आल्सो रेगुलेट्स द फिजिकल डेवलपमेंट, मेंटल डेवलपमेंट, सेक्सुअल डेवलपमेंट, नर्वस एक्टिविटी, द मस्क्यूलर एक्टिविटी एंड वेरियस अदर फंक्शंस आर परफॉर्मड बाय दिस वेरी ग्लैंड या बाय दिस वेरी हार्मोन दैट इज नोन एज थायरोक्सिन. द थायरोक्सिन कंट्रोल्स बीएमआर, बेसल मेटाबॉलिक रेट, physical development in our body, mental development of our body, sexual development of our body, the nervous activities in our bodies, and controls the muscular activities of our body. This is the function of the hormone that is known as the thyroxine. ये सारे काम जो होते हैं, ये सारे काम perform करता है the hormone that is known as the thyroxine. And after that, if there is the hypersecretion or hyposecretion of the thyroxine, both of them they are problematic for the person. And the hyposecretion, ये जो thyroxine होता है, अगर इसकी कम secretion, hypo means less secretion of this very hormone, that is a problematic. Hyposecretion in children, that leads to a disorder that is known as the cretinism. As you are seeing on your screen, the person who is suffering from the cretinism means the person that is having the less mental development, less physical development. And is jo person hota hai who is suffering from the hyposecretion of the thyroxine, that will result in the less या underdeveloped body, physical development उसमें कम होगी या mental development उसमें कम होगी या बाकी जो activities उस पे असर करेगा, the less secretion of the thyroxine. And a result is that the person will suffer from a disorder that is known as the cretinism. Cretinism जो आप अपनी स्क्रीन पे देख रहे हो, the ये person जिसको this very disorder that is known as the cretinism. He is having the short stature and also he is having the less mental, underdeveloped brain, yeah, less mental development इसमें होती है. That is the hormone that is known as thyroxine. After that, if the secretion, if there is the less secretion, this was the hyposecretion in children, yeah, hyposecretion in children. After that, if there is the less secretion of the same hormone, that is known as the thyroxine in adults. In adults, the hyposecretion of the thyroxine results in yet another disorder that is known as the mixed edema, yeah, that is known as the puffiness, or the disorder is known as mixed edema. अगर बड़ों में थायरोक्सिन की कम सेक्रेशन होगी तो उससे क्या होता है, उनमें भी एक डिसऑर्डर होता है, दैट डिसऑर्डर इज नोन एज द पुफीनेस, या दैट डिसऑर्डर इज नोन एज द मिक्स एडिमा. मिक्स पुफीनेस ایز پُفینس. پُفینس مینس سولن باڈی. أمِس ہسا چھِ گژھان باڈی چھِ ورم کھسان مِکسڈ ایما, دیٹ اِز وائی باڈی بِکمز پف پف لایک پف لایک, دیٹ اِز وائی دِس اِز نون ایز پُفینس. اینڈ دِس اِز رِزلٹ آف دَ لیس سیکریشن آف دَ ہارمون دیٹ اِز نون ایز دَ تھایروکسین, دیٹ رِزلٹس اِن اَ ڈِس آرڈر دیٹ اِز نون ایز پُفینس آر دَ مِکسڈ ایما. اینڈ یو آر سیٖنگ دیٹ پٔرسن ہوٗ اِز سفرِنٛگ فرٛام دَ ڈِس آرڈر دیٹ اِز نون ایز دَ پُفینس آر مِکسڈ ایما. آفٹر دیٹ اِف دَ اِف اِن اینی پٔرسن دیر وِل بی دَ ہایپر سیکریشن, اِف دیر اِز دَ ہایپر سیکریشن اِن اینی پٔرسن, اِف دیر اِز دَ ہایپر سیکریشن آف دَ سیم ہارمون that is known as the thyroxine, there will be the increased rate of metabolism, that means metabolic rate will be increased, and that will result in the leanness that will result in the leanness in the sense that means the ye jo person hota hai wo bahut patla ho jata hai because of the high secretion of the thyroxine. ha ye jo thyroxine hota hai it increases the rate of metabolism or rather catabolism ye increase karta hai, and whenever there will be the increase in the rate of catabolism the person will become lean, wo patla ho jayega, and us person ko aur ek disorder hota hai that is known as the exophthalmia. Yeah, this is also known as the Graves disease. The person who is suffering from the Graves disease, that is because of the hyper secretion of the same hormone that is known as the thyroxine. And what do by exophthalmia? Ophthalmia means that is related to the eyes, and exophthalmia means as you are seeing on your screen, the person will have the protruded eyes. Insanas hasa chhi ush outward bulging of the eyes gasan, and that is disorder is known as exophthalmia. And this is about the thyroxine. Having a quick recapitulation, so far we have seen the thyroid gland. This is the bilobed gland located in our the neck region below the larynx on in front of the trachea, largest endocrine gland. This is the gland which secretes two hormones. The first hormone is known as thyroxine and the second hormone is known as calcitonin. The first hormone thyroxine that regulates various activities in our bodies, like it regulates the basic metabolic rate, physical development, it controls physical development, mental development, sexual development, nervous activities, muscular activities. And after that, if in any person there will be the less secretion of the same hormone, that will result in a disorder that is known as the cretinism, in which the person will be of the short stature and he will have the mental underdevelopment. After that, the next, if the same hormone is secreted in less amounts in the adults, that will result in another disorder that is known as the puffiness or mixed edema. After that, if in any person there will be the hyper secretion of the same hormone, that will result in the leanness, that will result in a disorder that is known as ectothalmia or Graves disease. Now, the next hormone that is secreted by the thyroid gland, that is known as the calcitonin. And what is the function of calcitonin? This hormone that controls the calcium and phosphorus level of our blood. This much about the thyroid gland. And one more thing, in our previous times we were observing the people were having the swollen necks. That is also the disorder of the thyroid gland, and that disorder is known as the goiter. As you are seeing on your screen, the person who is suffering from the goiter. And here what happens, the thyroid gland that is having the enlarged size because of the deficiency of the dietary nutrient that is known as iodine. Because of the deficiency of the iodine, there is the increase in the size of the thyroid gland, which results in the swollen thyroid gland, and that disorder is known as the thyroid, goiter. And this much about the thyroid gland. After that, the next gland that is present in our body, in the endocrine system, that is known as the parathyroid gland. And this gland is present in the, they are actually the two pairs of yellow oval shaped glands, two pairs of yellow oval shaped yellow oval shaped glands which are present on the back side of the thyroid gland. As you are seeing here, the presence, the location of the and also the shape of the glands, that is known as the parathyroid gland. And the parathyroid gland, they secrete a hormone that is known as the parathormone. That is known as the parathormone. Yeah, this hormone is also known as the Kolb's hormone. This is also known as the Kolb's hormone. And what is the function of the parathormone or Kolb's hormone? That is very much simple. That controls, yeah, that maintains, this controls or maintains, yeah, regulates the calcium and phosphorus level of our blood. Calcium and phosphorus level of our blood by mobilizing the same, that is the calcium and phosphorus, from the bones whenever required, from the bones, and also by preventing its excretion, preventing their excretion through the urine. This is how the parathormone controls, regulates the कैल्शियम एंड फॉस्फोरस लेवल ऑफ आवर ब्लड. ये पैराथार्मोन हमारे ब्लड की, जो ब्लड में जो कैल्शियम एंड फॉस्फोरस होता है उसकी लेवल मेंटेन है, उसको कम होने देता है ना उसको ज़्यादा होने देता है. अगर कैल्शियम बॉडी या ब्लड में कम हो जाएगा, दैट विल ऑल्सो कॉज द प्रॉब्लम. एंड इफ देर इज द इनक्रीज इन द कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ द कैल्शियम एंड फॉस्फोरस, दैट विल ऑल्सो रिजल्ट इन द प्रॉब्लम. एंड सो द मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द कैल्शियम एंड फॉस्फोरस लेवल इन आवर ब्लड, दैट इज मेंटेनड बाय द हार्मोन दैट इज नोन एज पैराथार्मोन एंड विच इज सेक्रेटेड बाय द ग्लैंड दैट इज नोन एज पैराथायराइड ग्लैंड. एंड ये जो पैराथार्मोन हमारे ब्लड की कैल्शियम एंड फॉस्फोरस लेवल कैसे मेंटेन करता है, अगर ब्लड में कैल्शियम एंड फॉस्फोरस कम हो जाता है, उस टाइम ये क्या करता है, ये मोबालाइज करता है, या दिस takes the calcium and phosphorus. As you know, the just bones are made up of calcium, and so there is the mobilization, yeah, movement of the calcium from the bones into the blood, and by that there is the normal level of the calcium in the blood. And after that, next process, जिससे ये parathormone हमारे ब्लड की कैल्शियम एंड फॉस्फोरस लेवल मेंटेन करता है, दैट इज बाय प्रिवेंटिंग द एक्सक्रीशन ऑफ कैल्शियम एंड फॉस्फोरस फ्रॉम द एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम. ये पैराथार्मोन किडनीज में, या इट रीचेस टू द नेफ्रॉन्स एंड इट रीचेस टू द किडनीज, एंड इट हेल्प्स इन द एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ मोर कैल्शियम, एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ द मोर कैल्शियम, एंड प्रिवेंट्स द एक्सक्रीशन ऑफ कैल्शियम, एंड दैट कैल्शियम इज absorbed into the blood, and in this way the blood calcium level is maintained by this very hormone that is known as the parathormone. After that, if there is the less secretion, hyposecretion. Yeah, one more thing, this calcium and phosphorus level in our blood, that is very much important for the two activities, that is very much important for the nervous activity, that is very much important for the muscular activity. And if there is the hyposecretion of the what? Of the parathormone, there will be the less concentration, there will be the low level of calcium and phosphorus in our blood, that will indirectly affect our muscles, and that will cause the muscle spasms. Yeah, that is also muscle twitching. That will also lead to the muscle twitching. That means the contraction of the muscles, irregular muscle twitching, where sometimes we feel in our eyes, where our eyes twitch. That is because of the low calcium level in our blood, and that muscle twitching, muscle spasms, that are as a result of the hyposecretion of the hormone that is known as the parathormone, because there will be the low calcium, low phosphorus level that will indirectly affect the muscular activity, and when there will be the effect on the muscular activity because of the hyposecretion, that will result in the muscle spasms, that will result in the muscle twitching. After that, if the same hormone parathormone is secreted in the but higher amounts, that is if the hypersecretion of the same hormone occurs, then that will affect. I told you people that the parathormone maintains the calcium, maintains the phosphorus level of our blood by two processes, by mobilizing the same from the bones. And whenever there will be the higher concentration of the parathormone, this will reach up to the bones, and this will lead to the more mobilization of more and more and more calcium from the bones, and there will be the negative effect of the bones because of the hypersecretion, that will lead to the softening of bones. That will lead to the softening of bones, softening of bones, and this is the one negative effect. After that, the next thing, it was the next function that what parathormone does, that is the preventing. Yeah, it helps in the absorption of the what, the calcium, by the absorption of the calcium by the excretory system. And when there will be the increase in the concentration of parathormone, it will reach to the kidneys, more parathormone will reach to the kidneys, that will result in the greater absorption of the calcium in the blood, and there will be a deposition of, that will result in the deposition of calcium stones, deposition of calcium in the kidneys, yeah, in the excretory tract, yeah, as you are seeing, yeah, observing the calcium stones, stones are present in the persons of certain, we can say certain persons, certain kidneys of the certain persons, and that is because of the deposition of calcium. Those stones are actually the calcium stones, that there is the deposition of the calcium in the excretory tract, and this is how the the hypersecretion of the parathormone leads to. Having a quick recap of the hormone, but the next, this is the hormone that was, yeah, sorry, the gland, parathyroid gland, its location in the neck, there are two pairs of the parathyroid glands present at the back side of the thyroid gland. After that, they are oval shaped. After that, they secrete a hormone known as parathormone or Polyps hormone, that the function of which was the maintenance of calcium and phosphorus level of our blood. And it is hyposecretion results in the muscle spasms, muscle twitching, and hypersecretion leads to the negative effect on the bone, that is the softening of bones, and also the deposition of calcium in the urinary tract, excretory tract. This was all about the thyroid gland. Now the next gland.